Okay. So let's talk about what orthogonal trajectories are. The exercises I'm going to be looking at are on page 416 in your textbook. So first of all, just to introduce what orthogonal trajectories are. We look at families of curves. We say that two families of curves are orthogonal trajectories if, when we look at their tangent lines, form right angles. At points where the curves intersect. So we're going to look in the textbook over on page 410. And I'll come back to this in just a second. On page 410, over in the margin of the page, okay, a real simple one first. If you have circles, then their orthogonal trajectories, the circles are the pale gray. Their orthogonal trajectories are the black lines. And they show you, here's a tangent line to the circle. And, or I may have sketched that, and that may not be in your book. If you take a tangent line to the circle, it's going to be perpendicular to this line. Every time there's a point of intersection, if you sketch the tangent line to the circle and you compare it to the line that's being drawn, they'll be perpendicular to each other. So that's a simple example. And I'm going to have to turn this one upside down just to make it fit on the screen, but it looks the same either way. At the bottom of the page there, figure 6.16, here you have a family of inverse relations, either y equals c over x or x times y equals c. So those would appear in opposite quadrants. That's the black lines, or the black curves. And then the gray. Okay, what's the derivative of the constant on the other side?
Zero.
Zero. All right, this now becomes a separable equation. So since I just have two terms, I'm going to move one to the other side. And I'm going to want my x's on one side and my y's on the other side. Oh, wait, no, sorry. I want to solve for dy dx first. So to get dy dx by itself, we're just going to divide out this 4y. So we get x over 2y is equal to dy dx. Now this one is the slope for the hyperbolas. To find the orthogonal trajectories, we need the slope for the other family of curves. So, do you remember how we said we'd have to set up our differential equation? We take the negative reciprocal, so it's going to be negative 2y over x. So, we'll say for the new family of curves, we'll have dy dx is equal to negative 2y over x. Because if they're going to be perpendicular, then their slopes have to be negative reciprocal. Is that a differential equation that we are able to solve? Yeah, it's separable. So we're going to separate it out. We're going to do that on the next screen. So y'all finish writing this screen. We're going to flip the page. Okay, so our equation is going to become dy over y, and I left the negative 2 over here with the x. Any questions about where I got that equation? Does that one seem clear? What did I do? Okay, so let's go back to the equation that we had. We had dy over dx. Okay. So I know I want to move the dx over here. I'm going to do that by multiplying. And then I know I want the y over here. So here I could just multiply by 1 over y. So this gives me dy over y. And this gives me negative 2 over x dx. You just want the x's on one side and the y's on the other. Whose question was that? Okay, does that make sense, Amy?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, let's integrate those sides. What's the left side going to integrate to?
Natural log of y.
Natural log of y. And let's just make the assumption that y is greater than 0, and then we don't have to mess with absolute value. What's the other side integrate to? Negative 2 natural log of x. Let's assume that x is greater than 0 also. Then we don't have to mess with the absolute value. And then plus c. Okay? I'm going to go ahead and pull up this negative 2. So I'm going to make this ln of y equals ln of x to the negative 2. Plus c. And then this is in logarithm form. So I'm going to change it to exponential form. I know my base is e. I know whatever the logarithm is equal to, all of this will become my exponent. So we're going to make this ln x to the negative 2 plus c and then this will be my result. This is just from college algebra. You're changing from logarithm form over to exponential form. Since it's ln, your base is just implying to be e. This is going to be your result, and whatever's on the other side is going to be your exponent. That's from college algebra. Okay, here we can break up this addition. And what do we say about this? This can just be replaced by C. This is just some arbitrary constant, remember? So if we just want to call it C, we can call it C. So here we're going to have C e to the ln of x to the negative 2 is equal to y. Now what do we do with that e to the ln x to the negative 2? It just becomes x to the negative 2. So we can say this is C x to the negative 2. Or really, the way we probably would recognize it better would be to say y equals c over x squared, and that's an inverse relation. Now, I'm not going to do this necessarily on the tape, but this one right. So if we were to sketch this out, what you're going to have, what do we have originally? X squared minus 2y squared? So, just to take one example, let's just call C 1. You can call C anything you want to because you're going to get a family of curves. So you actually change its value. You do 1, then 2, then 3, and so forth. So, I would make this x squared over 1 minus y squared over 1/2. Because if I took 1 divided by 1/2, that's the same thing as 2. So what that tells me when I'm sketching these hyperbolas, I would go out 1 on x, and then I'd go out square root of 1/2 on y. The square root of 1/2, you may remember from trig, you may not, but the square root of 1/2 is roughly 0.707, so not quite 3/4 of the way, about 2/3 of the way up. And this is where you sketch your little box for your hyperbola. And then you remember your asymptotes have to go through the center and through the corners of the box. Do y'all remember doing this in pre-cal?
Yes.
Good, I like hearing a yes. If you don't, you can look at the pre-cal notes. Now, will this open up and down or side to side?
So on the test, you would just have to show this work. Any questions about that problem? You see if you awake over there? Looks like you're fading on me. Okay. So that's the last thing we have to do in section 6.3. We're going to go on now to section 6.5, and we're going to talk about first order linear. And this will be a relief to some.